We don't need another political.
Hello, this is Pastor Michael Wheaton, the senior pastor of the Bethlehem Baptist Church here in Paul's Valley, Oklahoma. And today I want to announce the release of The Secret to Your Best Life, the workbook, Understanding the Will of God Through the Word of God. And we'd like you to pick up a copy of this handy workbook with the new scan technology. So you can go through the book, The Secret to Your Best Life, learn God's plans, preparation, products, and path, and purpose for your life. And also, you can use the scan technology to go into a deeper understanding through watching videos and listening to MP3 file sermons to help bring out a better understanding while you're taking notes as well in The Secret to Your Best Life, the workbook. So we want you to pick this up, and it will be available within major bookstores in about 6 weeks. It's already available now on Amazon.com, and we'd just love for you to pick up a copy as well as Kindle. So we'd love for you to pick up a copy of The Secret to Your Best Life, Understanding the Will of God Through the Word of God, the workbook edition with the new scan technology. I don't believe that this technology is being used to teach the Word of God anywhere else. So get this book and also pick up other books that I have available. The regular Secret to Your Best Life, just the regular book, as well as How to Choose a Worthy Mate. And if you're going to be a part of my class entitled The Effective Bible Reader, pick up that before you come to class on Amazon.com. So we want to thank you for listening. May God bless you and keep you is my prayer.
We want to be this kind of church. That's why we're going through this whole book.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
This is the model of the church that I believe God wants us to be, to accomplish the vision that God has for us as a church.
Right.
And this morning, we're going to share a message titled Command to Preach. We're going to be looking at Acts chapter 10, verses 39 through 38. Would you please stand in reverence to the Word of God? Stand symbolically saying that I will stand on the Word of God. I believe it is four slides. Let's read this out loud together at the same time on three. One, two, three.
We are witnesses of everything you did in the country of Jews and in Jerusalem. They killed him by hanging him on a cross, but God raised him from the dead on the third day. He was not seen by all people, but by witnesses whom God had already chosen, by us who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and testify that he is one whom God appointed as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. While Peter was still speaking these words, the Holy Spirit came on all who heard the message. The circumcised believers who had come with Peter were astonished that the gift of the Holy Spirit had been poured out even on Gentiles, for they heard them speaking in tongues and praising God. Then Peter said, "Surely no one can stand in the way of being baptized with water. They have received the Holy Spirit just as we have."
Amen. You may be. So the order
they be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, we may ask Peter to stay with them for a few days.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Got a little happy. Again, we're talking about a command to preach, a command to preach. And this morning, we're going to talk about the proof of God, the preacher of God, and the power of God, the proof of God, the preacher of God, the power of God. And Christians should share the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Christians should share the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We're going to look at this brief video and get into the word.
A popular quote about sharing the gospel goes like this: preach the gospel always, if necessary, use words. The quote is attributed to St. Francis of Assisi. It was even the inspiration behind an award-winning gospel music album. First of all, there is no record that St. Francis ever said this. Secondly, it isn't biblical. The quote is often used to argue that actions are the primary tool for sharing the gospel, while words are merely a backup. But that's not the gospel. The word gospel means good news. It must be declared. In Matthew 28, when Jesus commissioned his disciples to go and make more disciples, he told them to teach. And that's exactly what they did. In Acts 2, on the day of Pentecost, the disciples went into Jerusalem and did what? Made sure everyone saw them miming the gospel? No, they went in and verbally preached about the events concerning Christ's death and resurrection, and 3,000 people were baptized that day. In Romans 10, the Apostle Paul tells the church to confess with their mouths. He writes, how will they believe in him of whom they have never heard? And how are they to hear without someone preaching? So the quote is true in the sense that it is necessary to use words, but false if the quote is being used to say that our actions are all the gospel we need. The gospel of Jesus Christ is history, a message that must be spoken. Our actions affirm that we truly believe in what we speak. So live a life of godliness. Yes, thank you, Smitty. And that's when we understand the text.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. A command to preach. A command to preach. We have been going through this book, and we have seen how the Spirit of God confounded the Jewish nation, and that God had a plan that the Jewish nation was not aware of. And his plan was to cause the gospel to go forward to all nations. This was his divine plan, and in order for this gospel to go forward, God had to get Peter on the same program as his heavenly program.
Right.
And Peter was told to go to a house that he wouldn't normally be caught literally dead in.
Come on.
Right.
He was commanded to go and to be there with Cornelius. But even Peter, as he went, did not know what God was up to, and Cornelius didn't really know, but God hooked them up.
Come on, man.
If I was preaching on that, I would say that God's got the hook up. He can put the right people in the right places to determine his plan and his program. God's got the hook up. For somebody, that's all you needed to hear this morning, is that God's got the hook up. You can get up and leave now, because you got a word from the Lord. Now please stay. That was just for free. But God put them all together because he had a program that he wanted to go forward, and his program was bigger than their culture.
All right.
Hello, somebody.
Yeah.
His program was bigger than their traditions.
Right.
His program would allow something new to be birthed in the midst of something that was old.
Come on.
Right.
Hello, somebody. I always like to talk about God being able to do something new in the life of believers and in the life of the church. Because sometimes God wants to do something new in our lives. Sometimes he wants to do something that has never been done before. But we've got to be on God's program. Hello, somebody. So, I said, we have to be on God's feet. So sometimes we don't need to just do it. Somebody always said none. Hello, say it's Peter. It's all God. No, this ain't the way it's done. It's always been done in the Jewish faith. God always don't want to end change. There's no want to say, I name the change. Name. I'm to fuck say this. Don't want to. It's a. Yeah, hello, somebody. Hope that's not change.
about what God has done for me, and he may not have done for me what he's done for you, but I can be a witness about what he's done for me. So I can be like that blind man. And they asked him about Jesus. He said, I don't know anything about you. All I know is that I was blind, but now I see. That's his witness. Do you have a witness? Are you a proof of who God is in this culture, in your family, at your work, at your job? Are you proof of who God is? Are you a witness? Did you see him for yourself? Ask your neighbor. Neighbor? Oh, neighbor. Did you see God for yourself? You see, if you saw God for yourself, then you can be a witness. Oh, say to your neighbor. Neighbor? Oh, neighbor. You're a witness to this thing. I'm proof of this. I'm proof of this. This is what Luke chapter 24, verse 45 to 48 says. It says, then he opened their minds so that they could understand the scripture. Yeah. And he told them, this is what is written. The Messiah will suffer and what? And raise from the dead, rise from the dead on the third day, and repentance for forgiveness of sin will be preached in his name to all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. And then verse 48 says what? You are witnesses of these things.
You are witnesses. Amen.
Problem in the church today is we don't have a witness.
No, mom.
Hello, somebody. We don't have a witness. We're not out there telling folk about Jesus. There is no witness. And if there is no witness, our church will never grow.
Right. Amen.
And I'm not talking about numerically. I'm talking about disciples.
Right.
I'm not talking about we need more members. We got enough members. Hello, somebody. Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah. Trying to pass the members like trying to pass the cats. Hello, somebody. The cats gonna do what they want to do.
Yeah.
A disciple is somebody who's a learner, who can be taught, and who will eventually get to doing the right thing.
All right. Right.
Oh, we may have some flesh issues, but a disciple learns what right is and does right.
Amen.
Hello, somebody. A disciple is a servant, as we learned this Sunday morning. That's what a disciple is. But a member thinks, they can do whatever they want when they want. Hello, somebody. So we don't need no new member. We need some disciples.
All right.
Man, we need to grow spiritually as well as numerically as disciples. But that will not happen if we don't witness.
Right.
Hello, somebody.
Good clue, Real.
We witness about everything else. Y'all heard me say this 1,000 times. We witness about everything else. When a good food place open up, we tell them, that's a good place to go and eat.
Yeah.
Hello, somebody. And I've said this 1,000 times where the bird said, God says, taste and see what?
That the Lord is good.
That the Lord is good. So why don't we talk about the Lord more than we talk about the favorite restaurant? Hello, somebody. You hear me say it all the time. We talk about bad news. All the time. Hello, the bad news can spread. Hello, somebody. But what if good news could spread? We saw what happened last week. That kind of stuff can spread. But what if we as the people of God begin to talk about God and witness about God, and Jesus Christ and his witness begin to spread within this town to where everybody's talking about Jesus as opposed to talking about other stuff?
All right,
man. Hello, somebody. Do we have a witness in this place?
Man. Yeah.
And hello, somebody. God says that we are the proof of who God is. And we've heard this 1,000 times. And if you were put on trial for your Christianity, wouldn't there be enough evidence to be convicted? Hello, somebody. Would they say it's only a misdemeanor? They're a misdemeanor Christian. Not a felony Christian.
It's a misdemeanor Christian.
It's just something that Jesus, just a little something. You know, every once in a while when I get mad, I got to tell some folk in my life, don't treat me like a sidearm. Hello, somebody. I'm not a side on, I'm the man in this. People like to treat God like he's a side on.
That's all right.
And he's just one of many things that you do.
Yeah.
And church is one of many things that you are involved in.
Yeah, yeah,
but
yeah.
Christianity is an all-consuming thing.
Yes, it is. Yeah, yeah. Yes, it
hello,
is.
Somebody.
Yes, it is.
And God has the right to command me what to do.
Right.
Hello, somebody.
Right.
And that's what he's doing this morning.
Thank you,
a command to preach.
Thank you.
He's not asking us to preach.
No.
He's commanding us to preach.
Lord.
Hello, somebody. Say, preacher, where you get that from? I'm glad you asked.
Ooh.
The next point. Tell somebody, the preacher of God in verse 42, he says, and what he said, he commanded what? Us to what? Preach to the people and what? To testify that he is what? The one whom God
appointed as judge of the living and the dead.
The apostle said here, he didn't suggest that we preach.
Right.
He commanded.
All right.
He commanded this thing.
Amen. Go do it.
He didn't give them an option to preach. Hello, somebody. He commanded them to preach.
Yeah.
Hello, somebody. And that's what God wants to do. And the devil knows if we could get this, if we could really get this. Oh, the devil ain't seen nothing yet. Oh, he's trying to stop us. He's trying to get us out of mission. He's trying to get us to minor on the minor things as opposed to major on the major thing. The major thing that God wants us to do as a church is to preach
the
good news. Hello, somebody.
Good news.
Hello, somebody. We preach about everything else.
Amen.
Hello, somebody. We tell and talk about everything else. Last night, what were we talking about? Most of us probably were talking about tornadoes. Bad news. Yeah, going to the cellar. Some of us wish we had a cellar to go to. but we talk about everything else, but we don't talk about God. And God says today, as a church, Bethlehem, that church, I want you to go out and preach. I don't want you to stop all this gossip. I want you to preach.
Yeah.
I want you to stop all this bad news. I want you to preach. Hello, somebody. I want you to preach about me in the same way that you talk bad news. I want you to preach about me in the same way you gossip in the street. Hello, somebody. I want you to say something about me. You are my voice.
Yeah.
If you don't say it, it won't be said.
Amen.
Hello, somebody.
Let's
change your name. Neighbor. It's time for us to preach. Hello, somebody.
Yeah.
We don't preach, there's no witness.
Yeah.
Hello, somebody. We live in a world where we multitask in so many different things.
Oh, my God.
Hello, somebody. We're kind of people that multitask.
Yeah.
So many ways.
Ooh.
God wants us to stop all this multitasking.
Lord have mercy.
Yeah.
And to focus on his mission.
Mm-hmm.
And his program.
Mm-hmm.
And his prayer.
Yeah.
And that is to preach.
Yes.
Hello, son.
Yes, sir.
That's what he said. He commanded us
to preach
to the people.
Right. Yeah.
Who is the people?
We are the
people of Paul's Valley.
Yeah.
Preach to the people that don't know him.
Amen. Right.
Hello, somebody. Preach. Oh, wherever you are.
Wherever.
In Norman, in Oklahoma City. Preach to the people. Vegas. Preach to the people. But how do I do it? All you have to do is to testify. Hello,
Testify.
Hello, somebody. If you don't know him, you can't testify.
Amen.
You don't have an intimate relationship with, you can't testify.
Right.
Hello, somebody. And that's a whole nother thing.
Yeah.
And that's what church is about. It's to help you to get to know him. That's what Sunday school is about.
Yeah.
To help you to get to know him. Wednesday is about to help you. Thursday, to help you get to know him. Men's Bible study, that's what it's about. To help you get to know him. To develop an intimate personal relationship with God. So much so that you will be bold enough to testify. Some people say, I'm too shy. That's a good witness. I'm too shy. Let me say,
all right.
You heard it? It's a town out of the... Everybody, this is coming. Oh, they're coming on. And they show us everybody is supposed to come what they think. I'm talking about it. And Jesus and our God demanding us this God to come out to the gospel of God.
Amen.
To testify of Jesus. Of him.
Amen.
Tell us somebody. Hello. I like this text said it was written to a preacher, and it's preaching the word. Our content is preaching the God Bible. We're going to apply the text the same things. Let's get from this text. Some 2 Timothy 4:2 says, in the of God, chapter, and a verse, and the presence of Christ, who will what? The flesh, the living, and the dead.
Lord.
Just in view of him appearing and kingdom is what? But he, I give you that his heart. Preach the word. Being what? Preparing season and season. Correct his review now and be prepared to preach it in God. He's a prepared, courageous, and courage. With rebuke, patience, and courage. In grace, and hello, soul. Preach the gospel. Know like the word of God, even if it's out of season. If you didn't really come, it's out of season. It's not a time where people really want to hear about it. I see here word right now. It's out of season. Oh, but God says, oh, do it in it. They don't want to hear it. But encourage him anyway. Great patience. You're not a preacher. But you still I'm not preach the gospel. Hello, the good news. You don't share it. Nobody else will. Hello, sir. No. Last week, keep us long. It's like this to what happened, and this what was new happening in the text. This is what this was happening. In verse 46, it's some gush. For they heard them speaking in tongues and praising God. And Peter had prayed something to say about that. This. See, Peter realized that when he gets on God's program, that God's power show up. When you get on God's program, God's power shows up. If we want to build a building, we got to first get on God's program. We got to turn it in our mind that we're going to build this building. We got to make practical steps to get it done. And when we do that, guess what? God's power will show up. Hello, somebody. It's already been showing up. He's shown us enough to let us know that this is something that we should be doing. But we want to say, well, show us a little more. Show us a little more. We're not believing all together.
Don't have faith. Yes,
we don't all together have faith.
That's right.
Because we believe in the circumstances.
Right.
We don't believe. You say, well, preacher, the building's not filled. Why do we want to build a new building? That's a good question.
Yeah.
Why do we want to build it? Because God said it.
Yeah, that's a good answer.
All right.
Yeah. God said it.
Tell us why we want to do it?
Yeah.
Because God said to do it.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
That's good enough for me. Good
Amen.
Amen.
Johnny.
Tell us.
Me too.
Yeah. He didn't say there would be difficulties.
All right.
He didn't say there wouldn't be trials and tribulations.
Yes, sir.
In the same way, he told oh, the disciples to get in the boat.
What's that, man?
Oh, he said, let us go to the other side.
Yeah.
Oh, and when he said that, when they took off, Jesus wasn't even in the boat, but he said, let us go
let us
to the other side. Oh, which meant that he was going to catch up. They didn't realize it.
Yeah.
They didn't realize it. He said, let us go to the other side, but didn't get in the boat with him. Hello, somebody get that on the way home to you. He said, let us go. See, they were going to have to do something without him first.
Right?
To show their faith.
My Lord.
Woo!
Yes,
somebody ain't getting in this moment. They were going to have to do something without him first.
Yes, sir.
Before he would show up.
Yes.
Come on. That's called faith. Hello, somebody. And he didn't tell them about the storm.
No, come on.
Hello, somebody. And when that storm caught him and they began to struggle. Hello, somebody.
Yeah.
Oh, and he showed up.
Yeah.
They thought it was a ghost.
Yeah.
But if they would have been listening in the first place, when he said, let us go to the other side, they would have been looking for Jesus, because Jesus said, we're going to go to the other side. We're in the midst of the storm. Oh, that's why. Oh, he's going to catch up.
Yeah.